Hi, I'm Matt Willis with the Marin County COVID-19 response update for May 13th. Today, I'd like to share with you a new dashboard going live tomorrow on our website to track our progress and provide measurable goals as we move on to the next phase of reopening. These are key indicators being tracked regionally by the 6 Bay Area counties that have moved together on the shelter-in-place order. Measuring the same things across the 6 counties will give us a better sense of our collective experience and response capacity region-wide, while allowing us to track important differences between counties. These differences may allow certain counties to move forward more quickly or more slowly in the reopening process. So this is the dashboard, Marin County Indicators for Assessing Progress on Containing COVID-19. There's 4 key indicators that are broken down into 1 or 2 different elements, starting with cases and hospitalizations. And this is an obvious reason, something that we should be looking at as we consider reopening further, which is that we are not seeing surges in cases. If we do see surges in cases, many people coming into our hospitals, we will need to halt any forward progress in terms of reopening, perhaps even need to ratchet back. So this is our current data in Marin County, and it shows that this is flattening the curve. This is what it looks like. This is a relatively flat curve of the number of people, the number of cases that have been diagnosed in the community. Next, as part of that same indicator of looking for surges, we have the number of hospitalized patients with COVID-19, and we see that the curve has generally been decreasing with a little blip here. But keep in mind, our axis here is just 0 to 10 people total. So we would expect to see some fluctuation within that range. The next is looking at our hospital capacity, indicator 2. Indicator 2 shows the number of beds that are being occupied by patients with COVID-19 in our hospitals. And we would be concerned, obviously, about moving forward any further if at least half of the people in the hospital were suffering from COVID-19. And that's the line there. So it shows that we have plenty of room, that our hospitals have plenty of capacity to manage any particular increase in COVID-19 patients. The next indicator is our testing capacity. And what this shows, we have set a goal of 200 tests per 100,000 residents. That's the state standard, that's a regional standard. For Marin, that equals about 500 tests on average per day. And what this shows is over the past few days, we've increased, these are daily averages based on averaging over the past 7 days. And what we've shown is over the past few days, we actually reached that goal of about 500 tests per day countywide. This also fluctuates because when we're having outbreaks, some days we may have 200 or 300 tests just related to one outbreak. And so we would expect that to come down again because there's been more activity. But it's reassuring that we are reaching our goals regarding testing. Our goal will be to be sustainably achieving that number of tests every day by the end of the month. The next indicator is around contact tracing. What this is, this shows the proportion of people who have been diagnosed with COVID-19 that we're able to reach through our contact investigators within 24 hours. Our goal is that we would reach 90% of people within 24 hours who have been diagnosed with COVID-19 to make sure they're successfully isolated. We also want to make sure that we've reached those contacts of cases, so those who have been exposed, and that they are able to be quarantined. We just started measuring this. This is based on a total of about 10 patients. And we will be continuing to monitor this over time. And finally, the last indicator for moving forward is having enough PPE. Everyone's aware that we've had national limitations on PPE supply, and we want to make sure that if we're going to be moving forward and potentially getting surges of cases, that our hospitals are prepared with enough PPE. And what this shows is that our 3 hospitals in Marin County have all verified that they have at least a 30-day access to sufficient personal protective equipment. So I hope this gives you a sense of the strategies that we see that are our highest priorities, as well as our commitment to be data-driven and transparent in our response on behalf of the communities we serve. Of course, we're tracking many other key metrics as we adjust and refine our understanding of the pandemic locally. For my part, I know how fortunate we are to have an army of healthcare providers, testers, contact investigators, and epidemiologists, the data brains behind this operation. Please check out this and other data about our response at coronavirus.marinhhs.org, coronavirus.marinhhs.org, under the Data tab. Thank you for staying home, covering your face, and doing your part to keep our curve flat as we gradually reopen.